I will praise you, Lord, among the nations. I will tell your name to my kin, Elohim. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy, Christ of mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, life of the faithful, glory of the humble, blessedness of the just, listen kindly to the prayers of those who call on you, that they who thirst for what you generously promise, may always have their fill of your plenty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The word of God continued to spread and grow. After Barnabas and Saul completed their relief mission, they returned to Jerusalem, taking with them John, who was called Mark. Now there were in the church at Antioch prophets and teachers, Barnabas, Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, who was a close friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul, for the work to which I have called them." Then, completing their fasting and prayer, they laid hands on them and sent them off. So they, sent forth by the Holy Spirit, went down to Seleucia, and from there sailed to Cyprus. When they arrived in Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in the Jewish synagogues. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O God, let all the nations praise you. May God have pity on us and bless us. May he let his face shine upon us. So may your way be known upon earth. Among all nations, your salvation. O God, let all the nations praise you. May the nations be glad and exulted, because you rule the peoples in equity, the nations on the earth in God. O God, let all the nations praise you. May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth fear you. O God, let all the nations praise you. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you. Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me, believes not only in me, but also in the one who sent me. And whoever sees me, sees the one who sent me. I came into the world as light, so that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. And if anyone hears my words and does not observe them, I do not condemn him. For I did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. Whoever rejects me and does not accept my words has something to judge him. The word that I spoke, it will condemn him on the last day, because I did not speak on my own. But the Father who sent me commanded me what to say and speak. And I know that his command is eternal life. So what I say as the Father told me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. We continue to read in the Acts of the Apostles about the first days of the church. And how it says the word of God continued to spread and grow, not on its own, but because it was being preached by the first apostles and those who they entrusted with the mission of preaching. Today, Barnabas and Saul, who received that mission from the apostles to go and to preach the word of God. especially as prophets, to go and to proclaim the word of God. And we do that in our words by professing our belief in Jesus, as we do when we come to Mass on Sunday, as we do when we pray. But we do it also in the way that we live. We have this office of prophecy, which is given to us so that we too can spread the word of God. Even in this time, it may be more difficult to witness to the Lord, we still have to find ways to do it, whether it's on social media or whether it's through the encounters that we may have with people in other ways, or even if it's simply by doing little acts of service to the members of our household. There are many ways in which we can be prophets to spread the word of God. And there's been no time like today when it's critical for us to accept that mission. So today, let's be prophets of the word of God in whatever way we can, by witnessing through our selflessness our faith in Jesus Christ. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness you receive the bread we offer, the fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. Become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness you receive the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme God, grant we pray that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but at this time above all to lodge you in your glories, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, we come with paschal joy, every land and people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and under willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my..." I've chosen you from the world, says the Lord.